Well, what are we doing now? So we're officially in, is this part four? Part three?
We'll just say part two of the Hall of Fame.
Right. You've got the hard line. There's no time. You're going to have to get to another exit.
See a set of keys around here.
No time for love, Dr. Jones.
No time for podcast.
I know, I can't be bothered with that. I have no time for that sort of nonsense.
Starting the recording early, eh? I can't hear you.
Test, test.
There we go. One moment while I crack open a beer. I got a mini fridge officially now in my office.
You never have to leave now.
No, I'm living the dream. You want food? I got hummus for you.
I never took you as a hummus man.
Hummus and pretzels, man. It's a good midday snack.
You gotta get yourself a hot plate in that office.
It's an option. It's on the table. I got like a 4 foot long side desk thing that I could put that on. So
I'm good.
I'd have about 40 plugged in things in here.
Whatever. Yeah.
How's life on your end?
All right. I've got low energy tonight, so you know that's good for podcasting.
Hey, low or no?
A little of both. Low to no, going on empty.
We're also toasting to me officially getting the Delta Silver status today.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So I don't know what it all means, but I'll take it.
You get the board a smidge earlier than everybody else.
Free upgrades, I've heard.
Sometimes.
But I already have a Delta credit card, and I think I get all the same stuff with that. So it might mean nothing. I don't know. And I do have to drop. I have to grab Axe at 9, so.
Yeah, I think we're just going to try to, like, we can talk about it when Jeremy gets here. But
put a bow on the last one.
Yeah, some cleanup and then talk about what we want to do next, maybe.
He knows we're paying by the minute, right?
That's one thing that we could talk about, too, is I know some people, they do, like, a green room thing where they do this chatting and stuff and then, you know, restart Zoom so they have a fresh 40.
Okay.
Not that way. It's one option. I started looking at some of the other software that's out there. Try to hook it up to different things, see how it worked. Zencaster looks pretty straightforward.
I've only been on like the front end of that admin setup part of it.
Yeah, it looks really, there's not even a login for it. You just kind of send links and You're part of the, there might not be a lot to do there, but.
That sounds good to me. Huh? Dude?
Hello there.
Oh, hold on. It's Jeremy. He put glasses on. I realize it now.
Now it's Clark Kent.
I think I was just somewhere else. I was in the video thing watching my something.
That's called a mirror, dude.
Newfangled mirror.
Well, what are we doing now? So we're officially in, is this part four? Part three?
We'll just say part two of the Hall of Fame. Where we left off. I think we skipped Jeremy on his Hall of Fame movies. We can do the what's everybody drinking to start off with.
I'm just drinking what I found in the some Fireball that I had in the cider from Angry Orchard, I think, one of those cider companies. I had some cider in my fridge and I had some Fireball. Things go together.
I fired up some cider.
I mean, I guess it's better than Diet Pepsi and, you know, warm tequila, but
it is better than that.
But much better, I don't know. And I'm drinking, I think I was drinking this last time too, but I got a fresh case of New Glarus Spotted Cow.
Oh, you got some Spotted Cow. I might come. We had one of those. We had one of those at Thanksgiving. It was Thanksgiving or Christmas. Well, I mean, I was there for both. You gave me one Spotted Cow and it was.
Yeah, and I got a buddy that went to Wisconsin to visit his in-laws and got me another case.
Yeah, that stuff was.
Tell you what, maybe on Friday if we see each other, I can give you a 6-pack out of it.
Actually, instead of that, when my mom comes in April, make sure to save one for me then.
Oh, I can do that too.
That's a ways away.
Yeah, I'm going to totally drink what I have by then. So yeah.
Well, maybe we'll get more.
I might know people, or I could also you know, drive 35 minutes to the border.
I'm probably actually closer.
Could be, probably. Yeah.
Do you still have any of that squirrel left over from the
Oh, yeah. You think I have some of that yet? Yeah, the errant case I bought.
Did you give Jeremy one of those while he was over? He's like, you got to have one of these.
They're really good. That might have been when I snuck to him on Christmas. I think I got that for Christmas because it's when we went up to up to Wisconsin. Right. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't remember what you gave me. I think I had one. Maybe I had two.
Yeah.
It's such a blur. I mean, I was so drunk.
Yeah, totally. That's why you left early. That's why you drove home early.
I'm drinking a Arcade Crusher by Topping Goliath.
We've been there.
We have been there. We have not been to New Glarus. We should probably do that someday.
They'd probably tell us to go home if they saw Minnesota IDs.
dual residency now, though, Peter.
That's true. Well, you do. I have a lot. I can't do it.
A plot of land. You could start, you know, like they do for those Scottish sell off just one square and say you're a Wisconsin resident. Just give everybody a...
Huh? I can do that? That's legal?
They do that for Scottish titles, yeah.
Huh.
You can become a lord or a lady with 1 foot of land, and they will sell it to you over the internet.
Really?
Yeah.
Just like stars. You can buy stars over the internet too, man.
Stars are free. Stars. We could start our own like star naming conglomerate, and people could buy them for money. It'd be just as legal.
Yeah. I looked into years ago, like the buying a star and naming it thing. There's no legality. Just they literally, it looks like a graduate certificate that says you now own the star. They probably send the same one. It's like, yep. Like who's going to fight you over who named that star?
I don't know. The National Star Registry seems pretty legit. So because it's into, especially in the days of the internet now, since that was a thing before the interwebs, from what I recollect, sure it's
which one of our friends do you think would have became a pastor online at some point?
Oh, pastor.
Yeah.
I thought you said would have bought one of those stars.
I bought one of those.
Yeah. We already knew the answer to that question.
Yeah, I figured. We've moved on. Pastor. That's a good question.
Do you think Jeremy would try to marry somebody legally at some point?
I'd try, and I'd fail.
I'm sure he's already done it. He probably just doesn't remember.
How much were those cost, Jeremy? Did you look into that?
$50. I think it's pretty cheap to get ordained online.
Yeah. No, yeah, it's like $30. You
can get, I mean, didn't Joy Tribbiani?
I haven't looked into it.
Everybody that we know that's going to get married or is probably married by now. No offense, Bruiser. So
there's time for second marriages.
I think everybody that's gotten divorced is probably there now too. Too expensive as you get older.
That's why you're going to have Jeremy do it for $35.
Yeah.
To renew that license.
I only charge $5 a wedding because I'm hoping to get 6 or 7 in and pay off that let man.
Yeah. That's probably just free drinks.
My end goal is pay that.
You might be able to slow roll it and do like a payment plan on it too.
Well, I mean, I took a loan out to get this license. There's some interest involved.
Yeah.
Loan shark.
A guy named Lenny that I don't really want coming over to my.
Oh, Lenny.
Speaking of the old internet, I did recently go on, it's still active. The Heaven's Gate website is still up and running.
What?
Who's running that? I thought they were all.
No. Some of them stayed here. Some of them didn't join in the mass suicide. There are still active members of Heaven's Gate. Still the same website 25 years
ago. Hey, why did you think to look this up? Just giggles?
You know, yeah.
He was really interested in joining something.
Apparently. Huh. You wanted some new shoes?
No, a coworker of mine had never heard of it. I was like, how did you never hear of Heaven? She's like five, six years older than me. I'm like, how did you never hear of this? So I showed her the website and I was like, yeah, it's still here. And I was like, oh my God, it's still active.
Oh my God, there's still people that...
So somebody's paying for it yet, right? I mean, I assume.
Yeah, they're putting in the $7 a month for the, you know...
The GoDaddy?
The GoDaddy.
Is Doe still on there?
No, I mean, it's just like the front page, you know, it's that the one, you know, you always remember for the cross kinds gate. It is purple and blue colors, the colors. Mm-hmm. And there's not much more to it than that. There's email address. Sent. I didn't send an email. I should send an email.
Geocities.com.
Geocities.
What was that? Peter, remember what was that? What was Philly's line about the Heaven's Gate people? How many astronomical units Pluto anyways?
Yeah, that's a dude we got to look up. If he's still around.
I've tried looking up Philly and it doesn't bring me anywhere near him.
Yeah, just not what you're, not the Google results you're hoping for.
What was his name? I can't even remember. Chris?
From Hearts. Not that I remember that.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, that is it. Yeah, good job.
If anybody was going to remember it.
I know. That was, yeah.
It's Steel Trap. Martin there.
Don't ask me what I ate for breakfast or what I just ate 20 minutes ago for dinner, but some random dude from 25 years ago, sure, why not? Who I haven't kept in touch with in that time. Yeah. I think it just sticks out because it had nothing to do with Philly, and he wasn't from Philly. He was from like a neighboring town.
Yeah, he was a suburb, and he definitely wanted called so bad.
Like me calling myself Minneapolis. I'm like, no, I grew up in Apple Valley, man. That doesn't fly.
Did I ever tell you a story, Pete, about the time I ran Philly at Target? And we were like telling mom jokes a lot then. And like, I ran then, huh? And he's like, hey, Jeremy. And I was like, oh, hey, Philly. And then like, I'm joking. Philly was like, hey, this is, she was like with him buying stuff at Target. Like moms do when you're in college, you know, they bring you to Target and buy you stuff. And I was like, oh, hey.
Hey, Philly's mom.
I just called you a whore. Sorry.
Wasn't the first time, but she doesn't know that. That totally is like you to not be able to read the room when he's standing next to like a middle-aged woman.
Yeah. No, you know, I have no surrounding perception. Like I am.
Well,
who's this, your older sister? Let's talk about your mom.
I didn't know you had a girlfriend, Philly. By the way.
By the way, you like the older ladies. So we're gonna do this Hall of Fame wrap up or what?
Well, you can't my movies. I actually just got eBay the other day my DVD copy of Nail Gun Massacre.
Oh, that's right. I remember you saying that was it on this last one that you said that was out there? And...
Yeah, I'd ordered it the last time.
Yeah, well, that's quick shipping.
Have you fired it up yet?
Oh yeah, I've watched it like it's not as good as I remember it.
Well, you don't say.
But it's a quality movie. And, I should look into it. I found my old VHS copy. I think I said that. Those things go, mine's not in great shape, but I mean, I have it in the box. They sell for like $100. Yeah. It's classic. There's lots of boobs. The camera kind of zooming in on the boob. There is, which I forgot until I watched it six times. there is male penis. I'd forgotten that.
Well, I really don't remember that at all. Of course, I don't remember the boobs either. So what does that tell you?
Yeah, one of the there's a couple that are having sex and they get killed by the nail. The guy falls to the ground.
Cool.
I was shocked. Like, I thought I would have remembered that.
Was it still flaccid though, or was it flaccid after that?
Here's the thing: is it's very flaccid scene where it flaps out, but he'd literally just been having sex.
That's what I'm asking. Like, yeah, I'm just curious. So it's
kind of the continuity doesn't really flow.
Yeah, I'm just saying that doesn't seem to follow science.
Yeah, if you're hard facts and Nail Gun Mask doesn't flow.
The other thing I'm trying to remember is, like, you know, this is what, the early 80s, right? Like 81, 82, maybe?
Yeah.
So how does he get a pneumatic nailer working just in random places?
Oh, he carries he's got a tank.
Huh. Okay.
And so he's got a tank on his back. The tank is painted, spray painted black.
Uh-huh.
He's wearing camouflage outfit, black motorcycle helmet. The yellow wire. Wire is yellow. From the gas tank to the gun. So it's like you're all camouflaged except for the yellow.
Yeah, it kind of defies the rest of the outfit, right?
Spirally wire.
You couldn't have spray painted that black or gray.
Well, I mean, they only had.
They spent it all on the motorcycle helmet.
And paying the dude to flop his tongue out.
So when you watch it for the sixth time, was it still surprising when his penis came out? Is it every time you're like, whoa?
It was better because you anticipate. In the later ones, you're like you have a new friend over to watch. Like I said, it was probably the fourth time I'd watch it again. And my old HR manager.
Violation.
I was like, there's gonna be some dong in 10 seconds.
Did you use the word dong?
If you knew my old HR manager.
It's probably why they're former HR, but okay.
It fits with that.
He sure wasn't a good fit, huh?
He too liked to flop it out once in a while.
So, any other movies you wanna?
I watched I bought Black Belt Jones.
Really?
As well as Hot Potato.
Hot Potato sucked.
Yeah, Hot Potatoes. Black Belt Jones, I remember really enjoying it. It's I remember it being racist. It's really racist. Like,
really?
Uncomfortable.
Maybe 19-year-old me didn't pick up on that as much.
Yeah, it's an uncomfortable movie. Like, it's not the movie I remember.
So we're not going to riff tracks that one?
No, we should not riff tracks that one.
Really? Is it that bad? I don't remember it all. Like,
there's the classic and things like
that's
that.
That's not racist.
Yeah, those are great parts. There's other parts that are... And it's also like I recently the Real Big Fish album, first album, very misogynistic, very racist. I was a little thrown off by like going to it and be that's
the one with radio.
What's that?
The one with like what, radio or
yeah.
Turn your radio on or whatever.
Listen to it again. It's rough. There's I still like the song. You know, some of the catchy songs, but it's not great.
Really? Well, now I'm intrigued.
I mean, Goldfinger hangs. You know, Goldfinger holds up. Like, that's just fun, punky, you know, jump around dance music.
Yeah.
Real Big Fish, not so much.
No, no point. No.
Not so much.
Less Than Jake, not so much.
That's a good song.
I always remember Less Than Jake the last time we went in and like, it was at, where do we see SDP? That place in St. Paul.
Yes? No, St. Paul, Roy Wilkins.
Roy Wilkins. They were at Roy Wilkins. And Johnny and I went there and we got a beer and we realized we were anywhere near the age of everyone else is like 14, 15. Getting dropped off by their parents. Mm-hmm. And Real Big Fish, or not Real Big Fish, but Less Than Jake plays one song and they say, who out there doesn't like homework? And Johnny's like, yeah, we got to get there.
And those guys were in their 30s at least at that time.
They were. We're not, this is not for us. We're not here anymore. And I still listen to Less Than Jake sometimes. I like those albums.
Johnny Quest, Vince Russo, come on. It's good too.
There's so many opportunities for me to play a song at the end of it. Yeah. You got somebody to pick from. Thanks. You're making it easy on me.
We try.
So that was movies. Did we ever talk about books all time for Hall of Fame?
I don't know if we got into, no, I think we just talked about the current year. Right. I think that's the way my,
I think you're right.
Probably should have listened to it again before.
You don't want to do any research before.
No. I mean, that involves effort.
You want to keep this fresh.
Yeah. Right. Hot take. I think you can splice things in and out.
Your favorite book series of all time, you guys?
And this will come up again. I'm a big fan of the, you guys might be a little surprised knowing me, but I don't get deep into like deep books or series by design. You know, I like to,
like the Bible?
That's, I guess, one example.
Can I guess?
Uh-huh. Sure.
Goosebumps.
Fuck you. Because you're mocking it.
He's a Potterhead.
No, after the first, 10 of them, I got tired of it. So, gotcha. No, never read a Goosebumps. Not even for my children. No, I like...
I know what someone's
not worth
getting
it.
For Christmas this year.
What was that, dude?
I said, I know what someone's getting for Christmas this year.
Hey, the movies aren't bad for kids, though. The Goosebumps movies aren't bad, but yeah, if you watch it and you don't have a kid, maybe it's probably a little sad. Or you're not with a kid.
I have definitely not seen
it. In the theater.
I'm just trying to make you feel bad in case you have seen it. There's a couple series. I like Nelson DeMille a lot. He has a couple different characters he has repeating. He's probably my... for the sort of action, it's not necessarily action. Sometimes it's more spy type stuff, but he's probably my favorite. Did
your dad read?
Yeah, that's where I got him. A lot of the books I read.
I thought I remembered him having them.
And then I really like the Lee Child series for Reacher.
Nice.
It's just, it's super just escapism, right? And then I also like, there's a certain author that wrote a zombie. I read a lot of, as you guys know, and I think I've brought up before. I read a lot of zombie apocalypse stuff just for shits and giggles. And I found one dude and I've read, he has one series that's 15 books and another one with the same character that's probably 7 or 8 books. And then another series with the same character that's 6 or 7 books. And I've read them all. He's just hilarious. That's Mark Tufo, T-U-F-O. And then if I'm going to go old school with one or two classics, I'll probably say The Count of Monte Cristo. For whatever reason, I always love that book.
But, and the sandwich.
And the sandwich. Obvious.
It's deep fried. It's awesome.
Don't judge.
I think I remember you talking about Count of Monte back when we were in college. I do remember you.
Well, that's where I got it. I was walking the shelves at at the library. Was that Wilson? No.
Wilson. Walter was on East and then Wilson.
Walter. Okay, I knew there's 2 W's and I couldn't remember which was which. But yeah, I just saw it when I was reshelving something and I, checked it out and read it and really liked it.
Jeremy remembers it, but he didn't go and read the book.
Well, he saw the movie with Jim Caviezel. So why rent the book? Why read the book if you can see a Jim Caviezel movie?
True. Every single one. That one, another one.
I can't remember actually. Oh, he did. He was Jesus in a movie.
Yeah, The Passion of the Christ. That was. We went years ago. We went to see that. It was Schwartz was there. Hefe was there. I think you were there, Pete, but I don't remember. We went that place that had the smash burgers together with the cheese in the middle, Tuggers or something like that. Tugs.
Tuggers.
We were there and we were having lunch and we were going to go see the movie.
Tuggers is a whole different place.
Yeah. And we're going to see the movie and our waitress / bartender is serving us. She's like, well, what are you guys doing today? And we're like, well, we're going to go see, we've got tickets to see The Passion of the Christ, which we ended up drinking and not going to see it. But we had tickets to go see Passion of the Christ at 12:30. And she's like, oh yeah, I went with my church group last week and all this blah, blah, blah. And she's like, are you guys really excited? Why are you going to see it? And I think it was actually Hefe who was like, he's like, yeah, we're going to see it for the exact opposite. We're going to see torture porn about Jesus Christ for 2.5 hours.
Hopefully you had gotten your food before then.
Right? I don't remember.
We're just dumb college kids. We didn't even think that through.
Damn. You still didn't see it though, huh?
I've never seen it. We were going to go see it that day. We maybe as par for the course, drank too much,
mm-hmm.
Missed our start time. Realized we were it was 1:30 their watch or something.
In the afternoon, yep.
Yeah, and said oh, the movie started over an hour ago. And it's oh shit. Well, I guess we're not going.
You guys got tuggered.
We got tuggered.
Tuggers. How about you, old man?
I got nothing.
Going back to when you read the Jack Reacher books, I started watching that, we're talking books now, but...
the Amazon Prime show.
Yeah. I watched the first couple episodes. Like, is it an accurate portrayal of... Because I've heard it's more accurate than the Tom Cruise, which
way closer to the... Yeah, like very, you know, dry sense of humor and very just imposing. Yeah, part of it is just the size and you know, how imposing his physical size is. That's an actual big part of the character, right? Because a lot of people don't lip off to a guy that's like 6'4", 250.
Yeah.
You know, somebody might lip off to Tom Cruise, who's like 5'8", 175.
I will lip off to Tom Cruise anytime I see
him. Yeah, so I'm just saying, like, he's a great actor, but, you know, Alan Richardson, I think, is the guy's name, and he's definitely fits the part more.
Yeah, no, I watched the first two or three episodes. I enjoy it. I mean, I'll finish it out.
And it got picked up for season two. That was like, you know, that was going to be my list of looking forward to this year. That was on the list for sure. So.
All right, I'm glad I spoiled that.
Yeah.
No, that's called a segue. What else are you looking forward to?
And this is a little bit more relevant, like a month ago.
Yeah. Ozarks, yeah. Did you watch it all already?
Oh, yeah. We watched like the first weekend it came out.
They dumped it all at one time. That's that.
The half season, right? They did two like 7-episode seasons, sure. I think, half seasons. So I don't know when the other part is coming. I'm intrigued.
You're looking forward to the almost conclusion of The Walking Dead, Peter Martin?
Yeah. I mean, it'd be nice to get that part of my life back.
Sunday evenings.
That I invest into that show. Is that this weekend it starts?
Yeah, it starts this
week. Right? Okay.
Do you know how I got my part of that life back from The Walking Dead?
Never starting it?
I stopped watching like 7.
You missed out.
Old man and I, we've held strong.
We started our own text thread.
Yeah,
it's called Just the Two of Us.
Why can't we let this go? That's the name of it. We wish we
Carl!
Could. Oh, Carl. Oh, I shouldn't say anything in case Bruiser ever goes back to it. Yep. And same, it'll be the same with the Fear the Walking Dead. I still have to catch up on this past half season. I'll get there.
Have you come across the spoiler yet? Like what's supposed to happen this season coming up?
No. I try not to. I'm really, just in general, trying not to review too much on spoilers. Like, there's a thing about Doctor Strange and, did you see these two potential cameos in the Super Bowl preview? And I'm like, I'm not going to look at them. I did the same with Spider-Man, and I was pretty happy by totally avoiding like reading anything about it. So
I think it'd be, Fear the Walking Dead, I think it'd be pretty happy. That's okay.
All right.
I'm into what's going to happen on Fear the Walking Dead. I mean, I think I'm about... I'm 17 or 18 minutes into the first episode.
Uh-huh. Yep. So you're still in LA. Yep.
Yeah.
No one's turned. It's just normal day-to-day life.
What's gonna happen next?
It's just a riot going on. Yeah. I suppose, it takes a little bit. Who's the brother? I forget what his name is. Greg?
I think I know what's going to happen in a talk it, or do you not?
Is it based off a comic?
Yeah, it's based off a
storyline. I don't know. I'm torn.
I won't say anything.
I really just want to see it and kind of be surprised. That being said, what I always have to do afterwards is read what I just saw, because I'm sure there's always going to be crap that, you know, non-nerds like myself won't pick up on. No offense.
I should.
Yeah. And I did that with like all the Disney shows too. I'd read like the little Easter egg thing. Yep. Had no idea what that was a reference to something else. Even like, you know, the building number is this. Well, that's the reference to, you know, this issue of the Avengers. It's like, I have no idea. Yeah. The internet is so smart. I tell you.
I always remember the best spoiler and worst spoiler that ever happened to me was, remember Nikki from college, second Nikki that I dated. And we went to movie Glass with Bruce Willis and Sam Jackson. Mm-hmm. And literally the very first time Jackson's in the movie, he's in like a purple outfit and had a cane with a ass top. I just remember Nikki just leaned over to me and she goes, and I was like, whatever. And like, she's like, how is he not the villain? His name's Mr. Glass. He's wearing a purple outfit and he's got a cane, the glass. And I remember at the end of the movie, I was like, God damn it. She's right. Like, yeah. Of course he's there. Right there.
What other stuff are you looking forward to for 2022?
Gosh, I mean, there's a bunch of TV stuff coming out. I'd have to look and see what the
New Maisel starts, I think, this week too.
Is that this week?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, I'll watch that. I really appreciate the show. Marvelous Miss Maisel.
Oh, I haven't watched that yet. I don't know. I've heard it's good, but
it's good. It's a really well done show, and the main lady is hilarious and attractive.
I've heard there's Westworld.
Yeah, there's supposed to be this continuation
too. What? So I didn't see season two or three. Am I missing anything?
You can skip season two and go to see who's better.
I mean, realistically, I'm like, is this worth investing more my time into? My time's precious. Yeah.
Yeah. So good. I disagree with old man. Season two. I've watched it all. I've watched it all three times through, and I'll watch it again one more time before. I think it's just better TV than most.
Yeah.
There's that. There's so much TV out there.
Yeah.
There is.
True.
It's tough. I mean, good.
The hard part about Westworld, it's not a show you can be like distracted. Like you can't have the kids on the couch with you, like yelling at you. You know, you got it. Like everything matters. There's no waste.
Yep. It's not something I can watch like while I'm working and have it on in the background. Yeah. I know I have to be alone, you know, kids in bed.
You got to invest in all of it because there's just so much. And it's almost maddening that it's like, I kind of want something that I don't have to like pay such attention to. I like to multitask. I like to have comic books out, a book out, my laptop, and I have most going at the time. Yep. Like it's driving me nuts right now that I'm
and Snowpiercer.
Yeah. And I mean, I have my TV on mute in the background on a cooking show so I can look occasionally. Because that's just how my mind works. But Westworld is like, you have to like, you've got to watch it all because you miss one thing and it's like, which is infuriating. It's like, why does it have to be that?
Yeah. All right. Well, all right. Maybe I'll pick that up and see if I can get into season two. I think I watched like the very beginning of, or maybe watched the first episode, but it took me a while to get through season one as well, though.
Season two is the worst. I mean, it's the worst of the three. Great.
Yeah. And you kind of have to watch it to know what's going on somewhere.
Yeah. Yep.
They take the problem. The biggest problem is they make it for the sake of story that don't make sense.
Yeah.
And that's disappointing. Like, you know, I'm always, you know, Robert Kirkman, who does The Walking Dead, as we're talking about before, you know, like he writes, you know, there's different types of writing styles. And Kirkman writes, he will always have characters go out of character to advance his story. Whereas I prefer the writing style of character, but sometimes you suffer, but as long as your character's nature, it's a better story to me. And that's where season two of Westworld suffers, is that's where they take the season one and season three don't take those. Season two crams story into characters that would not necessarily act the way Jeffrey Wright's character and Evan Rachel Wood's character act out. And it's frustrating because you've now invested, like, well, no, they wouldn't, but it does advance the story in the way you want it to. Is that necessary? Maybe the story would be more interesting to follow those characters would actually, if that makes
Peter,
sense.
Peter, Aaron Paul shows up in season three. So there you go.
Yeah.
There's your hook in right there.
I am. Well, actually, that's a couple other things for this year. I'm looking forward to the next season of The Boys because I really like The Boys.
Mm.
I've enjoyed, and I'm sad that Peacemaker, the last episode of the season, comes out tomorrow. I've thoroughly enjoyed Peacemaker. And then Better Call Saul. I'm excited that the last season of Better Call Saul is coming out because that show's become really, really good. It was a very slow burn the first two seasons for me.
It cut out on you.
Yep.
Better Call Saul. I'm, I think, season three, episode two of the other one.
Okay.
So I've basically gotten back to where I was previously.
So you started from the beginning again?
I started from the beginning again, and now I'm, like, slowly going to new territory.
And would you agree, like, the first season or two, it's a little slow?
It is a little slow, yeah.
Certainly the first season.
And then I totally forgot the actress, the Aaron Paul's girlfriend, was the same lady from Jessica Jones.
Oh, yeah.
Netflix. So I was like taken aback. Like I didn't remember that at all because she was only in the last few episodes of season two.
Yeah, she wasn't very long.
So it was kind of weird when you go back and it's like with movies like that too. It's just like you see somebody that like in Band of Brothers that you hadn't seen before, but they show up, you know, a decade later and something else. And you're like, they had so many actors in Band of Brothers that went on to do other things. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah. I think Jimmy Fallon's the best one, right? Cause I think he drives a Jeep for like one scene. He's like the best cameo. And you're like, it's Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah.
Super. And he's literally in it for about 10 seconds.
Yeah. And like Schumer's in there. And Schwimmer's in there.
Schwimmer's, you know, he's just a dick in there. Anywhere. Yeah.
Oh yeah,
Poe Dameron, like, and also like the, you know, Inside Llewellyn Davis, like those were the movies that took me to him. And then suddenly now I watch all these before that, and it's in every.
Yeah.
He's just a line of head. Like he just shows up, like he shows up for one scene and leaves or whatever, you know. But oh my god, like forever.
And that show's gonna be fun to watch too. I think Moon Knight looks pretty.
Yeah, I love Moon Knight. It's crazy.
Yeah, I mean it's supposed to be pretty violent according to Feige. So
you read any like?
Yeah, that's what I'm curious about. If they're, I mean, they're still keeping it on Disney, but I don't know if it's going to be something at Disney where they're going to start actually using more not mature, but like in a, yeah, an older rating.
Well, I think what they're thinking, and I don't know much of anything other than what I've read a little bit. They own most of Hulu at this point. Disney does. And so they might just have the non-PG&G stuff over on Hulu, but we'll see. We'll see how that
works. But Moon Knight's going on Disney. That's where I'm like, well, that if it's borderline.
Is that a movie or is that a series?
A series. No, it's a series, but it's going to be on Disney Plus. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see what they do with that. And certainly if they pick up, you know, Daredevil or some of the rekindle those old Netflix shows or Punisher, which would be, I mean, like those would have to go on Hulu. I can only imagine.
Those shows just, they got, if you go on Netflix right now, they just got takedown notices on them, all of them.
Yeah, they're, yeah, is it this end of this month or something like that? Where they're going to be
pretty quick if you haven't.
I don't know if Disney's going to, you what?
I haven't watched them. I got a power through. It's so weird. I being the comic book guy of the friends, Andy Larson, have not watched most of the Marvel TV shows. Like, you guys have all watched stuff. I haven't watched any of it.
Well, you start with The Punisher is the best, and then Daredevil's right there. First season of Daredevil.
I watched the season of Daredevil.
But season three was the best, for sure. The last season of it. Jessica Jones is okay. I think the Iron Fist was the least favorite.
I think Jeremy liked Jessica Jones quite a bit. There's some mind-bending bullshit in there, too.
I mean, David Tennant's in season one was solid. It's good people. The Iron Fist, yeah, that's the one. Yeah, that one was not great. Season two actually wasn't too bad. Season one was not, I didn't find very good at all. There's two. Every one of them had two or three seasons. And then there's one season of The Defenders.
Yeah, The Defenders was good. That season was good, too.
That's right. It's interesting to get them all pulled together. But yeah, season two of Iron Fist actually isn't, like I said, it's not too bad. The ending's pretty cheesy. Literally the last scene, I was like, really? But
yeah, Punisher's.
I think that's just, they're like, well, we know we're not going to get renewed, so F it.
We'll just kill everybody.
I just got the Disney Plus and I've been watching. I really enjoyed Falcon and Winter Soldier a lot. And then I watched WandaVision, which I enjoyed. Like, I don't think I'll ever watch it again, but like one watch through was good. But I really enjoyed the last episode. Vision Wave is like coming back, him away, and then the Vision says to Wanda, what was the line? He's like, you know, we've said goodbye before. And then Wanda says, well, maybe we'll say hello again. And yeah. I thought that was very beautiful. Like, great. Like, it was a very emotional, for a TV show, it was a very emotional moment.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't cry, but here might have cried a little.
I cried.
Wow. I'll admit, I cried.
I might have teared up.
But did you enjoy The Mandalorian? Or I should say that, the Book of Boba Fett, old man. Because I'm guessing Bruce hasn't seen it yet.
I watched the episode.
Yeah, it gets, that's another one that gets better.
I heard it gets, I'll watch it all. First episode. Yeah,
it does get better after the first few, but it's not, it's not amazing.
It basically turns into season 2.5 of The Mandalorian.
Yeah, I kind of like hand it over a bit. It's like, what?
What just happened?
Let's admit it. For three guys who've spent 40 years waiting for something more about Boba Fett, pretty goddamn disappointing.
No, we literally found out how he survived, and then Baby Yoda showed up and like saved everybody. So
yeah, he's quite honorable, apparently. You cannot besmirch the man's honor in that show. If you
just, way more than Han Solo.
Just a bit. Yeah.
Did either of you watch Station 11 on HBO Max?
I have not.
I haven't either.
You should watch that.
I've heard.
Will Arnett one?
No, it is just end of times kind of thing, but
with like flash, right? I mean, it's one of those things that jumps back. Like,
yeah, it's really good. It's on a lot of people's top tens of last year, and I finally watched it like the end of January, and it was really good.
Yeah, maybe I'll power through that.
Did you guys watch After Mayor of Easttown?
Yeah, that was really good.
Oh, mm-hmm. That's one of the best shows. The best. That was True Detective.
Yeah,
was the best, closest thing to True Detective. I mean, I guess it has. Bartleby.
Season three of True Detective was what, 2.5-3 years ago?
Yeah, yeah. It was.
It was Ali guy. I forget how to say his name.
Does anybody know if they're doing any more Fargo seasons? Or are they?
That's another one I fell behind on too. I kind of lost interest in the
different stories.
Ian McGregor season.
Sure.
Yeah, that one was.
So I never.
It
I didn't.
Was good in the end, but it was rough in patches.
Yeah, I mean, I think I got 4 episodes though. Probably something, you know, during the drought, I'll toss on and finish the last 2 seasons because seasons 1 and 2 are really good.
Yeah.
The last season tried to tie some of it all together, like the different storylines of everything over the last
four.
It was kind of interesting to see.
Yeah, damn it. I'll probably have to watch that too.
All you got is time, Peter.
It's true. I just do a lot of it when the kids go to bed. My wife goes to bed early one night, and I'm like, all right, well, I'll power through two episodes.
When you're not podcasting?
Yeah, when I'm not busy. I'm a busy guy. I don't know if you guys know that. So
are you telling us that are you powering Yellowstone?
No.
Which is apparently the most popular.
Yeah.
In all time. In all of recorded history, Yellowstone is the most popular.
Yeah, the viewership on that, like the numbers, is absolutely insane. It's
people love the Kevin Costner.
The fact that the spinoff show, the 1883, is also massive.
Yeah.
It's going to be a third spinoff. They just announced today.
That guy that writes all that stuff is going to solely keep Paramount Plus afloat by all by himself.
He's like the Dick Wolf of Westerns.
Yeah, he should really get the name Dick Wolf of Westerns. Like, that's his name.
But that reminds me, they're bringing back Law and Order with Sam and a couple of the old characters.
Anthony Anderson.
I think Watterson. I was, thank you. Couldn't remember.
On Pedestrian TV? On regular?
Yeah, on NBC.
Wow.
It's like, well, we're done trying to figure out something new that people give a shit about. So let's see if Sam Watterson still alive.
Someone dig up his corpse.
Yeah, well, it's been how many years since he was on? 10, 12, 13, 15?
Like Peter wouldn't watch a zombie apocalypse Sam Waterston law show of some sort.
Yeah, hold on one second. What dude? All right, hello. All right, you going to bed? All right, love you. All right, good night.
There's the thumbnail.
What?
Just go to bed. Is there something wrong with it? We don't have enough time for that conversation.
Yeah, is there something wrong with me? Is that what's going on?
Go to bed. I love you. Go to bed. Strange.
Pardon the interruption. The question is, what do we want to do next more than anything for the podcast? Like, do we want to try different styles? I know Jeremy brought up like doing a riff tracks thing, or we could do different styles of different other podcasts and see like what's fun. And you could do something like Smart List where they bring in a random guest that the other two hosts don't know about, and then you have to basically interview them. You could also, there's a one I listened to for a very brief period where you basically do a draft. You know, you pick a topic, you do best books of all time. If someone picks that book, then it's out and they got a, you know, fantasy football draft kind of style.
Okay.
And so, you know, somebody might steal your pick. You know, you do best McDonald's $2 entrees or whatever, and you do a podcast about it, something like that.
And I still think it'd be fun to do like favorite family trip, or I'm just trying to think of what else would make sense to.
What was that NPR podcast that got popular with true crime about the high school kid who maybe killed his girlfriend?
Are you willing to kill your girlfriend? Is that what you're saying?
No, it's like the 10-parter. It was like the true investigative.
Yeah.
What if we did like one of that into an incident from our college year? We like did a investigative crime.
A deep dive.
Is it like the Always Sunny where they're trying to figure out who pooped the bed?
Yeah. Who pick some random incident and try to see who remembers what.
Who broke my ankle?
And interview. That was me.
That's what I was thinking. It's like, that'd be a great one.
That was me. Probably.
Interviews with people from the night, you know?
That'd be hilarious, but...
A deep dive. We find Rob from way back when. The guy from upstairs that, you know, may or may not kill people. I don't know.
There was somebody that did a book of their college years that was like chickens, kind of a chicken soup of the soul kind of book, where it was just all their college stories, or, you know, reminiscing. You could totally do something like that in a podcast form where you like interview people about things. But I don't know. There's lots of possibilities. I don't know what you guys want to try to do next. We could talk about it more over text and different things too, but
yeah,
we'll figure something out. I mean,
I like the idea of doing a riff tracks of, but we'd have to do something that was relatively short. 2-hour movie would be a little rough podcast. Yeah,
that's up to practice.
Yeah.
I've never done anything like that.
There's a lot of dead air.
Right.
Yeah.
What if we did a riff tracks of one of the classic movies we watched, Porn Sunday?
Yes, no.
Of course edited for, you know.
Yeah, was that the one that was it was like, yes, no, your words confuse me, and then that's where we came up with what it meant to be French. Oh, she's French, that's why she does that. Okay.
Oh yeah, she's French, I remember. Makes total sense.
Yeah.
And there could just be a moment in the middle of it in praise to the classic moment where Amanda's mother came to visit the house. We're moving off and we were all watching porn together in the living room. And Amanda's mother came in, you know, Amanda Mather's mom came into the living room and we just had a blue screen on the large TV in the living room. Like 12 of us just sitting there staring at a blue screen.
And what Amanda, are you doing?
Later, Amanda was like, yeah, that was way weirder than if you guys were watching porn. Like, mom would have been more comfortable with you guys watching porn than sitting around blankets over all of each other watching a screen.
Yeah. No one thought to change it to a different channel of any sort.
No. Yeah,
just stop.
We've never been smart people.
Not quick thinkers, anyway.
Well, if I would have had the remote in my hand, we would have been fine. Muscle memory would have just switched it.
Muscle memory from when you're 15 and you had cable.
Yeah. And trying to watch a scramble.
Alrighty, boys. Yeah, we'll figure something out. We'll text.
Yeah. All right.
But, well, thanks for getting together. Good times, as always, seeing you guys. Old man, are you going to come out Friday?
I don't know. It's so far away.
Yeah. Is that a mile?
I'm going to leave work. I get done with work at 3:00 on Friday. I'm going to come home and I'm going to walk the dog. And then my friend Spike, who used to live here, he's going to take Bartleby for the night. I'm going to stay at Andy Larson's so I can drink at Casper's. So I'm going to drive up to Andy Larson's and go with him to Casper's. So I will be there all night on Friday night, if that's enticing at all, friend.
You'll be at the sports barn?
Yeah, I don't know what this fucking Casper or whatever it is. I guess I'm going. I'm excited because I don't ever go out anymore. I'm so paranoid about going out, but I'm going to do it and it'll be good.
There's a family restaurant on one side and then there's a sports bar / garage / barn on the other side. So
if you guys come, do not let me into the family restaurant side of.
Well, you have to go through there to get to the bar.
Yeah, it's kind of a dual entrance. You kind of, I guess temporarily, you might like for 2 feet, and then yep.
It's kind of a split entry, kind of.
Yeah.
Well, I'm very excited. Andy Larson was super excited. I texted him on the side. I was like, Andy, can I stay at your house that night? Because then I don't have to worry about driving back to Northfield. My friend will watch my dog come just stay at your house and ride with you. And he was like, yeah, party night. And I was like, all right, sweet. I don't plan on still.
Famous last words.
This is the place that has the covered wagon out in front, just so you know.
I know nothing about
that. I'm just saying. It's
right next to a Wendy's.
It's fancy. Yes, it's right next to a Wendy's.
You can top off with a Frosty.
Yeah, I will probably get a Frosty and then throw up in Wendy's.
Perfect.
they request you only go through the drive thru.
I'm going to need, Peter, at the beginning of the night, I'm going to need to borrow your driver's license for the night.
Uh-huh. Go on.
Just in case anything happens, I want to be able to give the proper ID authorities.
You can totally pull off me.
Just wear a hat.
Take the glasses off, and we're twinning.
Twinning. Also, he'd like one of your credit cards, if at all possible.
Which one do you want, buddy?
Two of them, actually.
Just in case?
Just in case.
One with points and one with cash back. That would be great.
I haven't given you the story about what happened at work, but I do technically have a work credit card in my wallet with a $4,000 limit. So, just saying.
So, you're buying?
So you're buying Casper's?
I can buy Casper's for $4,000?
There's a chance.
Dude, don't offer that high, man. Offer lower.
Well, yeah, don't start at the top, right?
Start at 4,000.
Don't come out with your best bid. That's a rookie mistake.
Is that a daily limit or is that a...
I haven't tried it yet, so...
All right.
All right, guys.
All right. Good night, boys.
Later.
We'll see you Friday. Yep. Probably right. Not.
You will.
No.
Don't make a stop by. I'm just saying.
You don't know where I live.
Yeah, right.
Bye!
There's no time for last requests.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Look, Betty, I've got no time for games today. Now,
there's no time for a bench test. Heat 'em up.